Managing your cash flow and your personal expenses are very essential for getting consistent profit in your Shopify store and making your store to a long-term brand. Hey Avengers, welcome to another video. In this video, we're going to talk about finance and how can you manage your cash flow for running a consistently profitable Shopify store and again reinvesting those profits in your store for scaling your store to the moon without getting bankrupt. Before starting, make sure you press the red subscribe button and press on the bell icon and press all for getting all my future video notifications at the first. The first thing here is that whenever a person is ordering from our store, that order value, that money is not transferring to our bank account within the same day. I'm using PayPal as my payment gateway, but PayPal is not allowing that money to be transferred to our bank account within the same day. It is taking at least 2 to 3 days for the money to be transferred to our bank account. So we should keep this in our mind so that whenever order has been placed, we have to continue our Facebook advertisement or other advertisement, whatever you're using, and we have to fulfill those orders. So we should keep in mind this thing, and we have to keep some investment left to our store so that we can fulfill those orders within time and can continue our advertisements without any interference. The second thing that I'm going to talk with you about is some of the charges that we have to fulfill per month. It is first includes Shopify payment, Shopify charges, Shopify store maintaining charges, some of the apps that we are going to use in our store that also include some monthly payment subscription charges. And if you are using some fulfillment service like Silk Road, you have to pay some monthly charges. We have to keep in mind, I am using Extra for finding out my products and I have to pay monthly charges for that I have to keep in mind, and you should also keep in mind if you're using those services for you. So whatever order has been coming, with those orders only we have to fulfill all those payments and the charges. For you should keep in mind this thing also. The third thing that I want to talk with you about is scaling your store. It's very, very interesting and very good to see that you can make money. You are making so much money, and if you are getting those big numbers, millions, it's very, very interesting and exciting. But with this, there are some issues that will come up. They may come up with your store also. Is first, PayPal may hold your money to be transferred to your bank account. You should keep in mind this thing also, that it may come to your dropshipping journey also, because if you are suddenly and quickly scaling your store, it gives an indication to the PayPal that we are doing some scams or doing some wrong things so that we are getting money for this. So for that only, PayPal may hold our money. So we should have some investment left in our bank account so that we can continue fulfilling our orders and can keep on scaling our ads. But once you have resolved all these issues, they have sent all the documentations, tracking ID, everything to PayPal, they will remove the holds. That's not an issue at all. But we should keep on mind this thing. And for this one, I will recommend one app that is must for every dropshippers out there, is the PayPal tracking info on autopilot. It will save you lots of things because it will keep on sending tracking ID to PayPal every time, so that PayPal can understand that we are scaling our stores, that there will be no hole left by the PayPal in our store. This app is very, very essential that should be installed in every of our store, every stores that we are running right now. So this thing we should keep in mind very much, and we should have left little bit investment in our bank account so that we can fulfill our orders. That we should keep in mind this thing. The next issue that comes up is not able to cope up with the order volume that is coming to your store. So whenever you're scaling your Shopify store, you should keep an eye on your suppliers' volume demand. That how much that your suppliers can able to fulfill your orders. According to it only you should scale your store. Not like that you have scaled your store to a larger extent and then the orders of the volume of your orders from your store is very, very high, but you are not able to cope up with those orders. So whenever you're starting your advertisements, when you're importing your products, you should ask your suppliers within how many days you can supply those orders, and if we are giving you more orders, tons of orders, what are your order fulfillment capacity. According to those only you should choose your supplier and start scaling your ads. Whenever you're choosing a supplier, you should talk with them about this first. This is very, very important, because if you are not able to fulfill those orders on time, you would be getting chargebacks. That is very, very bad for any Shopify store. If you are getting chargebacks, that means your customers will be unsatisfied. They will give a bad review on your Facebook page, which will be leading to banning of your Facebook ads account. You cannot make again ads for those from this page again. And if you are getting more chargebacks, then PayPal will ban your PayPal account also, so you cannot get those money to your bank account. So you should keep in mind on fulfilling your orders, and you have to see that your suppliers can be able to fulfill those orders on time. The last thing that I want to talk with you about is reinvesting your profits or the money that you're coming from your dropshipping store again to your dropshipping brand for growing it to a higher level with a profit margin. I know you'll be making so much money from this store, but whenever you're making some money, I'll suggest take some money and keep it in savings, so that you can reinvest in those money to back to your store for growing your Shopify brand to a higher level. So whenever you are getting some money, keep it in savings or try investing those money just in your store again. Don't just take your money and throw it here and there for buying your new house, new cars. I know you will be doing this one, but not at the starting level. When you have a consistent long-term growing brand going on, that time you can use those money for growing your fulfilling your wishes and all afterwards. But in the starting, you cannot use this money, because those money you should again reinvest in your store one more time for growing your brand. Whenever you're making money, then try uploading new products in your niche. Try scaling your Facebook ads, growing your Facebook ads pixel, make it mature how much data you can feed to this Facebook pixel. It will help you to grow your store and make it a long-term incoming money coming source. Make sure you keep it in mind these things. Whenever you're getting some money, just try uploading new products, try scaling your Facebook ads. Once this has been done, you are getting some money, then again try to take those money and again start one more brand, one more website on those products, on another niche, and try scaling that product, those products and those store to a long term profitably. I'm not saying just scale it, profitably scale it to a higher extent, and keep on making more and more stores every time when you're getting some money. So from those all the stores, when the money will start to come, those money, if you want, that will help you increase your brand. Suppose, for example, a Lamborghini may help you increase your brand pricing, because whatever I have seen is that an iPhone is a symbol of brand that is helping the people for growing their brand. That's what's going up. So after this all these things you can buy afterwards, but at the first I'll not suggest. Don't just spend those money here and there. Just try to take those money and reinvest in your brand. After you think that you have created tons of stores and you are making good amount of profits from all of your stores, then try scaling your stores, or try to take those profit and try investing in different businesses like real estates, golds, and some other source of income, so that money will keep on coming to your bank account and it will not stop. Money should not stop coming to your bank account, and you could keep on cope up with the life, and you can grow your life to the fullest as possible. All these tips was from me to you, Avengers, for making a consistent, profitable, long-term dropshipping brand. And let me know in the comment section which tip you have liked the most and you are going to use in your dropshipping journey right now. And give this video a big like, guys. If you want to see how I'm making money online, then make sure to check these two cool videos out right now.